If you haven't been circumcised again, we will come for you. Puccino is here. My friend. Look at this
guy! This one is the knife for circumcision. This one is the
What is up, beautiful people? So today you're coming with me to an event at the Uganda Museum. The Uganda Museum is right at the heart of Kampala City, and I'm sure you will have fun on this one. So let's go! This right here is called the Kadodi Carnival, and it is in preparation of a bigger festival that happens in August, and it is to celebrate the Bagishu culture, the Bagishu tribe, the people from the eastern part of Uganda, and it is showcasing lots of dances, lots of activities, all the artifacts, the instruments that they have, the cultural wear, and mostly the dances. So stick around, I have a few facts to show you.
It is very good, more than nine special, more than that's a light, more than soda, more than water, more than a wife.
Which tribe is this in Uganda?
This is a Bagishu tribe, like with the Wamasawa from the east.
Yeah.
Lambule is Ronko.
Yeah.
That's all Wamasawa.
Oh.
Yeah, that's where
the Bagishu is. Like the traditional way?
Yeah, exactly. This is the traditional way.
Yeah.
But in half of it, because it just came like it was abrupt, but then
they're presenting
with other people.
Yeah. And then you're just like,
Besonja mulote.
We have something to present, maybe you can. Maybe just some few minutes from there, you can take a video.
I will definitely.
All right, it's okay.
Yes. Besonja.
So how do they play this game? Because I'm seeing you guys are holding, what is that?
If it falls in the middle, they give you what
What is in, what you targeted, right? Alright, let's see you throw. Is it like free? Is it free?
You pay 1,000.
Yeah.
They give you 5.
Oh, okay. So that's like less than a dollar. No, oh, okay.
Anyone say you're Cuba?
Yeah. Oh, you didn't. It's just in the middle. I think you shouldn't do blindfolds again.
Thank you.
we've come to the coffee site, coffee table.
Maintaining the culture, but also promoting prosperity within the community.
Okay.
Now this one is called Luluero.
Oh.
Luluero is a winnower. Now this Luluero was like a dining or like a plate, a big plate. Now this big plate, they would put here food and all the children would sit around.
Wow.
Now the purpose of it was that as children sit around, you as a parent, you look at the children how they are eating their food. Now, if you see your child is eating food, but the mouth is making a lot of noise, then you know this child might have some
issues.
It's not gentle enough. Because food in our culture, you determine somebody's character and the patience from the level of patience with the food.
Ah, okay.
This one is for giving luck to young boys who are about to be circumcised. This one is our musical instrument.
It's a
We use it during festivals of marriage. Maybe you have had a good harvest. Yeah. Then you use it to make the community members enjoy. Wow. So this one.
This
boat, as you see, it has two openings.
Twins.
When you get the twins, you put milk here, then a straw here. To invoke the issue of sharing. Now this one is a knife for circumcision. It is only sharpened using this stone. We don't use those other stones or machines. No, it is this one. And as you see, it is shaped in a way that when the circumciser grabs it, he gets the grip and cuts without missing. Circumcision is a must in our culture. Because it is a passage of rite from boyhood to manhood. When you are a boy, they call it omusinde. Omusinde means that you are the pillar. There is no way you can dodge circumcision in our culture.
Oh, really?
If you eat 20, 21 years and you have not been circumcised, they will use the other method by grabbing you and they look for you. So the best thing is you allow it to happen willingly.
Yes.
Yeah.
So but I think if you're like a baby, they can easily do that. What is it that they have to wait until you have it old enough and then that is what they do?
You know, our culture is that every stage from infancy, the responsibilities are different. Childhood, the responsibilities. Youthhood, the responsibilities. Teenagehood, the responsibilities are different. So for you to enter into manhood, you must go through this pain. You are a man and you must withstand circumstances that are happening. I give you the chance to tell me when you will be circumcised, but I don't give you the chance to tell me when you will not.
So let me ask you, how do they know that you have to be circumcised? How do they know?
You see,
age
groups.
Age groups.
They will know. Say, Julius, his age group is so and so. He has never. They will begin doubting you. Now, when they doubt you, they will do an investigation. They can even send a woman. If you are so
good,
then they send a woman.
Yes,
this woman, once
she feels that
there is, you are not circumcised, then he tells
them, they come for you.
They will not have peace. Your turn has come. If you want it, voluntarily, please come and stand. If you can't do it, we are going to show you. And then they circumcise you.
No more circumcision, like from the hospital has come about.
Yeah, once you take the hospital one.
Yes.
It is also okay.
It is also okay.
In culture, it is not okay.
It is not okay.
But as a human being, we allow it.
Yes.
But in our cultural norms, values and practices, you would have missed some values.
Oh.
Because if you went to hospital, you cannot become a care person of the client. You cannot become even in. In the politics, we may not vote you as a member of
parliament.
Because you didn't vote.
So to all the Bamas who are watching this, if you haven't been circumcised, we are coming for you. We're going to look for you.
Please tell them.
Please come and tell whoever, just do the traditional circumcision. It's an experience.
If you are above 25 years, really, and you are hiding here in Kampala,
you are hiding in Kampala,
you are hiding in the US, you are in London,
I heard California.
One time when you come back, believe me or not,
we shall know. Yeah. We shall know,
and we shall come.
We shall come for you.
So, you see the city.
Now we circumcise every 1 year, during even years. That's when we circumcise. Now this year, 2022, is a year for circumcision. And as Bama Saba, we have the opening ceremony. And the opening ceremony takes place at Mutoto Cultural Grounds. It will take place on the 6th. And that is when we shall open for our boys to now to be circumcised fully.
Of August.
2022.
Yeah. Wow. I think I should also come at that event. I don't know. Am I welcome?
In fact, you are welcome.
I am so welcome. Yeah, oh,
you are welcome.
Okay.
Come, be part of us.
And then I show you how it's done, how people do it, and how they enjoy, just like this beautiful event here. Right?
Come. Yeah, we will.
All right, thank you so much. You're from Dancing.
The title of our culture is called Umukuka.
Umukuka.
Yes.
So does he have a palace? Where does he sit?
Umukuka right now, it's in Maruku. Mm. That is where we have the royal palace.
Yeah.
But we are there temporarily because we have a site where we are supposed to, we are planning to build a palace.
Ah.
And it's called Mutoto. And that's the place where they launch Imbaru. So this is Imbaru year.
Yes.
Circumcision year.
Yes.
Every event year is circumcision year.
Yep.
Imbaru is one event that brings millions of people.
Wow.
Because when you talk of Masabaland, it's not about Bugisu. Bugisu is just a subsection of the whole region. We are over 70 million people.
Wow.
So when we are launching Imbaru, all these people come. Okay. And every family is involved in Imbaru on one way or the other.
Wow.
So it is the second, it's rated the second biggest carnival in the world.
In the world.
Just second to Sambo Carnival.
Wow. Tiny grand church houses.
Okay.
What are they?
These are this is where we are at Uganda Museum.
Yes.
Now Uganda Museum has every tribe has a hut here, has a cultural hut here. All about your culture, you put them there. And this is more like a cultural village.
Wow, for Uganda.
Yes.
Yes.
Our circumcisers are born.
They are born.
The clans that produce circumcisers. So it's an orientation that you go through. You don't go to school
to become a circumciser.
No, a doctor is not a circumciser. It's a cultural, and the knife they use is cultural. It's just hewed from metal.
Oh, wow.
Yeah? Where Imbaru started for Bama Saba, where it started is where we launched it from.
Thank you so much.
Nakumbuka kama kumbuka.
Events are just beginning, so I will see you in the next video. I hope you enjoy.